Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today we're going to spend a little bit of time and talk about anodes and just how important they are when it comes to protecting your stern drive, your outboard, your inboard outboard, whatever it is. If it floats in the water, you need to protect it, because what happens when you put two dissimilar metals down into a water solution is basically you're creating a battery, because that's what a battery it is. You've got an anode and a cathode usually sitting in some type of electrolyte, and that transference of metals creates a voltage, and that's what happens when you put your boat into the water. What you want to do is add in a less noble metal that is sacrificial. Instead of actually eating your drive, that sacrificial metal gets eaten up. Now, on a typical outboard, you're going to find them in a couple of locations. The first one is going to be down low on the transom, and it usually is mounted like this. Now, the second location actually has a dual purpose. One, it is an anode, and the second, it is a trim tab. What a trim tab does, it actually compensates for the prop walk and makes the boat track straight by compensating it one way or another. Now, on most of your smaller displacement outboards, that's typically the only two locations that you're going to find. Now, if you step up in horsepower, you're going to find that they actually have anodes that are attached to the engine itself, because let's face it, you've got water that's traveling and traversing through as the cooling system that's actually going up through the engine itself, and that needs to be protected. Now, at least once a year, I would recommend that you go and pull those to make sure they haven't been eroded away. Now, when do you actually need to replace an anode? My rule of thumb is once they are worn by about 50%. And if you're not sure what 50% looks like, why don't you go to our website, bring up what a new one looks like, and then compare it to what's on your boat. More than half of it's gone, it's time to replace it. Now, the second type we want to talk about as far as the engine side goes is a pencil type. And that is typically used in a situation where you've got an inboard outboard setup with a heat exchanger. And at that point, it's pretty easy to identify them because it looks like just a regular brass plug. The trick is you unscrew that brass plug and there's going to be an anode that should be screwed into the end of it. But there's no way to check that unless you go ahead and pull it. I've seen occasions where people just completely overlooked it for years, and guess what? It was completely eaten away and starting to do damage to that heat exchanger, and heat exchangers are not cheap. So once again, once a year, pull that plug, make sure there's at least 50% of that particular anode left, and then you're good to go for a while. Now, the other thing I want to caution you about is sometimes a year is too long. Everything may be electrically sound on your boat. It's bonded correctly. It's grounded correctly. All is good with yours. But what about the boat next to you? Its electrical system may not be up to snuff, and it could attack yours by sending over stray current and prematurely eating away your anodes way quicker than it should. So you want to check as often as possible. You're out at the beach, anchored off somewhere, put on that dive mask, go down and at least take a peek at your exterior anodes to make sure they're good to go. Because once they're gone, guess what? It's going to eat your drive alive, and I've seen that happen as little as 2 months. I would know because it happened to me. So something to be aware of. It's not a lot of fun having to replace a drive that's only a couple of years old because somebody else had an electrical problem next to you that you didn't know about. Well, all right, guys, this is just a basic overview of anodes and just how important they are, and to keep an eye on them because they will literally save your boat, your engine, your outdrive. Well, listen, if you need help finding what is going to fit on your particular application, why don't you send us an email or give us a call, and we'll be glad to direct you to whatever is going to be required for your particular make, model, and year. Listen, if you have any questions or comments, why don't you leave them in the section below, and we will do our best to answer them. Hey, you like what you see? Why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on or talking about next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.